talking to you about the love of God today, the love that brought me to a relationship with God, my Savior, laid his life down for my sin, and I'm compelled to accept him as my Lord and Savior over 20 years ago. Yes, I've been born again 20 years. Jesus says, a man must be born again to enter into the kingdom of God. He knows that you're a sinner. He knows you've fallen short of his glory. And this is why God saw and loved the world enough to give us his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall inherit eternal life. What a promise that is, ladies and gentlemen, eternal life with God. To live in a way that is pleasing to God. God knows all your talents to be used for his glory, and shortfalls. Every day we don't measure up to God's perfection, but we are created in the image of God. Hallelujah. And we're made to serve the Most High God. And Jesus is known as the Kinsman Redeemer. He came as a man, the Son of God, the Messiah, born of a virgin, as it says in the Bible, book of Isaiah, chapter 7. It also speaks of this in other holy books as well, which you must understand. A lot of the holy books other than the Bible calls Yeshua, Yesha, or Jesus, the Messiah, born of a virgin. In the Veda scripts, the Prajapati sacrifice, and the Quran as well. To know Jesus' love for you is what brings us to God. Nobody wants to come to a God who we know is going to judge the world. Many of us know that God will judge us one day, and it terrifies a lot of people. So why should we come to such a vindictive, judgmental God? Well, because God provided a lamb for your sin, called Jesus Christ. That's why. That's why that his mercy is through Jesus, his Son. And Jesus says when he returns, he will judge the world. All those who have followed their own lusts, have tried to plan their own lives. Yes, God has given you life, but he's given us freedom of choice to give our lives back to him, as he's laid his life down for us. He wants you to give him your life in order that you might be glorified. You're created in the image of God. Hallelujah. The Bible talks about beast empires, beasts of the field, where they try to reign and rule over the world through many different means. And the Bible predicts all these events right up until Jesus' second coming. In Matthew 24, Jesus gives us about 12 prophecies of his second coming. There will be wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes in diverse places. Things will fall out of the sky, meteors. People's hearts will grow cold due to lack of love for God, lack of love for one another. I tell you today, if you want to know God as your Savior, he will fill you with the spirit of love for him first and then for your fellow man. That's what Jesus came to do. Lay his life down for your sin. He's the hero of all ages. Even the star signs in the sky represent the Messiah. From the virgin, Virgo, to the lion, Leo, Leo the lion. Jesus comes through the virgin as the Lamb of God, and he returns as the all-conquering lion of the tribe of Judah who judges the earth. And it says it is blood on his garments because he's judged the earth. This is how Jesus comes back. Hallelujah. But do you want to know him today as your Lord and Savior? You have that chance to hear the word of God, hear the gospel, hear about what the holy books say about Jesus Christ, the Bible, the Quran, and the Vedas, the Prajapati sacrifice. How about the Messiah, Jesus, in the Quran that you skip over, you don't read it? Why? It says that Jesus is the Messiah, the anointed one of God. And you say that Christians follow a man. No. Christians follow the Messiah. He's more than a man, and fully God, is Jesus Christ. And he died on that cross and bled for your sin. And it's very important how you understand the gospel. Not that important which church you go to. Yes, pick up a King James Bible, but it's far more important that you understand about who Jesus is and what he did for you on the cross. Jesus says to his disciples, "Who do you say that I am?" And Peter said, "Some of them say you're Elijah, some say a righteous man, a prophet, perhaps even John the Baptist, but who died." And then he said, "Peter, who do you say that I am?" And Peter says, "You're the Son of the living God, the King of Israel, the Messiah." And Jesus said to Peter, "Flesh and blood has not revealed that to you. All you need is a revelation of Jesus Christ for yourself. Don't tell me you don't understand. I don't understand. I couldn't understand the Word of God. Nobody can understand it unless they get a revelation about Jesus Christ. And they get filled with God's Spirit. Then you're given understanding. Then you're sealed unto the day of redemption. Your soul is sealed unto the day of redemption." Ladies and gentlemen, how many chances will you get in your life to let that seed, that eternal life, fall into the good ground of your heart? Are you still going to resist God, resist the Holy Spirit? Is it going to harden your heart towards God? Or when that word is preached, are you full of the cares of this world? The weeds are the cares of this world, the lusts, the possessions, the power, the money, all the things that this world strangles the Word of God within you. If you're a Christian backslidden, it's not once saved, always saved. Hallelujah. God bless. What can make you whole? the Word of God, that God is love. You know what love is? It's a selfless thing. Some of us would lay our lives down for our family and friends. Almost all of us, I think, would lay our lives down for our family and friends. It's exactly what Jesus did for your soul. Very simple, what the gospel is. Jesus gave you power over the enemy, over sin, over death, over diseases. The apostles had power to cast out demons from people. A lot of these demons caused illness and sicknesses. How many of us know people who have died of cancer and have got illnesses? How many people know that Jesus still does miracles today? Many people have been healed of cancer, AIDS, different things, just through prayer, just through faith in God. And so it says in the Bible that you can't please God without faith. Just like if you're planning for your life, maybe you're doing a course, you're working on something, you've got to have some amount of faith for you to complete that project. And so when you look at God's creation and you understand that all His creation have fallen short of God's glory, that we're all sinners, and that the Bible repeatedly talks about God providing a lamb for the sin of His people. It talks about this in the Vedas as well, in Hinduism, called the Prajapati sacrifice. None of the Hindu gods fulfilled that sacrifice. It means that the sacrifice which takes away the sin from God's people. Only Jesus Christ fulfilled that sacrifice. And that's why there's like 50 to 100 million Christians in India. Probably more Christians there than there is people here in the UK. But that's beside the point. How about the Quran? Yes, the Bible says in the Quran that Jesus is the Messiah, that Jesus was born of a virgin. It speaks about Jesus' death and resurrection in the Quran. God leaves all of us without an excuse. It's written down, Surah 355, Surah 1933. You've got John 3:16 in the Bible that says, God so loves the world that He gave us His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. And it's talking about a spiritual birth and life. That there's a part of you that lives on after your physical body dies. Physical death is not the end. In fact, most of the major world religions talk about life after death. Most of them, they cover billions of people. They talk about life after death. They talk about a spiritual realm. They talk about God judging you for your sin. But understand this, that Jesus died on the cross so that God judged your sin on the cross. And when you look to the cross, when you look to Jesus, your soul is saved through faith. Oh, thank you, sir. Would you like a CD? Okay, thank you. Hallelujah. You look to the cross. Praise the Lord. And your soul shall be saved. Just as I did over 20 years ago. Some of you might have. And the bad seed has fallen on good ground, where the Word of God is being fed and rooted and it's growing in your life. Or a Christian can let the cares of the world strangle that Word inside you and produce a spirit of fear, a spirit of whatever, that the Word of God is not growing properly, or that eternal seed can hit a hard ground, which means you've hardened your heart towards God. You've hardened your heart towards the Word of God. Now, Jesus Christ is referred to as the Word of God many, many times. Not just in the Bible, in the Quran as well. Yes, absolutely. He's referred to as the Word of the Living God. Do you know Him? How is your relationship with the Father, with the one true God, through His Son, Jesus Christ?